worship him in the midst of it all. Let us learn to worship him in the midst of it all. And the midst is when I don't want to. That's when the worship is the greatest. I don't want to love you, but I love you when I don't want to. I'm in the midst of worshiping God. And when he does not give me my way and he takes something away from me that I want, I yet worship him, says I'm in the midst of what I don't want to be in, but I yet worship the one, because without this life that he gave me, I wouldn't be in the midst. So I ain't got nothing else that God has for me. I understand it. I don't have all the money that I want. I don't have this. I don't have that. It don't even matter. Without life, I don't even know I don't have it. I need to get down to the basics. And when I get down to the basics, I worship him for the life that he gave me, so I can know you, or know my circumstances, or know my situation, or know my bondage. I'll start appreciating him. You got to appreciate before you can appreciate. See, y'all, most of y'all don't even appreciate yet. Appreciate yet. Of means now you can add appreciation to somebody else's life. But y'all ain't even to the point, some of us ain't to the point of appreciating God, let alone appreciating. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. We thank you for what you're about to do. I couldn't do what was about to take place. I am a waterer, I am a planter, but you are the changer and the increaser. So as you increase us today, Lord, let me sit down when you tell me to sit down, stay up as long as you tell me to stay up, and don't let me be disobedient in either way. Yes. And as I do this, I'm going to thank you in advance for the increase that you're going to bring into all of our lives, yes, a life we would not have if you had not chosen to give it to us. Yes. Along with that life came my circumstances. Along with that life came my children. Along with that life came my wife. Along with that life came my church. Also along with that life came people who didn't like me. Also along with that life came people who talk about me. Also along with that life came people who hated me. But I'm not thanking them for them. I'm loving them for the life you gave me. So they are only blessed because I'm giving back the love that says you have been chosen by God. Yeah. We thank you now, Lord, for all things this day and forevermore. Amen.
Amen.
Man, it's hard to preach in a prayer like that.
Yeah,
it's hard to preach. Praise the Lord. Wow. I ain't in love no more because of what nobody's doing. I'm in love because I got life.
Amen.
And the fact that I got life says I've already touched God. Wow. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Somebody say complete.
Complete.
Look at your neighbor. Say,
hey, neighbor.
Complete.
Complete.
Now, most of us, we accept being half a man and half a woman.
Amen.
And then when we get together, we become one marriage. But a boy and a girl are not to be married. And if I'm half a man, I'm a boy. If you have a woman, you're a girl.
Amen.
A whole man,
amen,
is a man.
Amen.
A whole woman is a woman.
Amen.
Yeah, we all right?
Yeah.
Okay, but complete. And as we hear this, I'm going to read this. Matter of fact, you know, I like the way Pastor read. I'm going to let her read this for me today. And then y'all know when most times when I get her to read, I let her get her that brown mic over there. Most times when I get her to read, handle that brown mic. Most times when I get her to read, that means I'm gonna walk part of this with her. Matter of fact, I'm gonna read it, then I'm gonna let her walk us through it. I'm gonna read it, then I'm gonna let her walk us through it. If I could speak all the languages of the earth, please stand, and of angels. This is sometimes you want to stand, sometimes you don't. I do whatever God tells me to take you to do. If I could speak all the languages of the earth and of angels, but didn't love others, I would only be a noisy gong, a clanging cymbal. If I had the gift of prophecy, and if I understood all of God's secret plans and possessed all knowledge, and if I had such faith that I could move mountains but didn't love others, I would be nothing. Man. But if I, it says, If I had to give a prophecy, and if I understood all God's secret plans and possessed all knowledge, and if I had such faith that I could move mountains but didn't love others, I would be nothing. If I gave everything I have to the poor and even sacrificed my body, I could boast about it, but if I didn't love others, I would have gained nothing. Love is patient, love is kind, love is not jealous or boastful. Love is patient, love is kind, love is not jealous or boastful or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It is not irritable. It keeps no record of being wrong. It does not rejoice about injustice, but rejoices whenever the truth wins out. Love never gives up, never loses faith, is always hopeful and endures through every circumstance.
Yes.
Prophecy and speaking in unknown languages and special knowledge will become useless. But love will last forever.
Yes.
Now our knowledge is partial and incomplete. Even if the gift of prophecy reveals only part of the whole picture. But when the time of perfection comes, these partial things will become useless. When I was a child, I spoke and thought and reasoned as a child. But when I grew up, I put away childish things. Now, we see things perfectly, like puzzling reflections in a mirror. But then we will see everything with perfect clarity. And all I know now is partial and incomplete. But then I will know everything completely, just as God now knows me completely.
Yes.
Three things will last forever. Faith.
Yes.
Hope.
Yes.
And love. And the greatest of these is love. Pastor, if you will, I want you to switch over to the King James Version for me.
Yes.
Switch over to the King James Version for me. I want y'all to hear this. I want you to read. Well, let me just expound and just go to King James Version for me. Take some. Many of us are complete and we don't even know it, but most of us are incomplete, trying to make ourselves complete. And you cannot complete what you did not make. You cannot complete what you did not create. Men have a problem. We want to complete our wives. We want our wives to be just like we want them to be. And if they become what I want them to be, they'll never be complete. Because I did not create them. Hello, somebody. You can tell when you are children and try and beat them into completion. But what I'm trying to say to you is, if you got a, and then ladies, if you got a man that you can't respect, get you a man that you can respect. My point is, if you got a man and he's asking for respect, there's something wrong with the picture to begin with, because he's asking what only belongs to God. Because respect equals honor. We all right? I need you to sit here, and if I got to tell you I'm the man, deep down inside, I know I'm a boy. Because I'm not talking to you, I'm talking to me. I'm trying to justify to me that I am what I want to be, that I'm not yet, because I'm still incomplete. I cannot complete myself. I can't complete my wife. My wife, even if my wife comes loving God, and I come in loving God, and she's a whole woman, and I'm a whole man, she still can't complete me. And as much man as I might be, and I might not be a boy, I still cannot complete what I did not create. I got to this place because God brought me to the place of being a man. Pastor, if you read verse 4 for me.
Praise the Lord. Charity suffereth long.
Charity. In the King James it read today, it read love. Charity is giving and not expecting it back.
Amen.
We need to stop saying love and start saying charity.
Right.
And then you'll understand what you're supposed to do with love.
Yeah. All right.
See, because the problem is when I say love, I love you, you love me. You don't love me, I don't love you. But I'm not operating in the form in which God says I should operate in love, and that is to give it, not worry about what I'm going to get back, because it is something to be charitized.
Charitized.
It must be something that is charitized, something that I freely give away. I don't care what you give me back or not give me back. So we need to stop saying I love you and say I charitize you. I'm giving you this freely. I'm giving you what you need to complete you. As much as I'm equipped with. And the closer I get to God, the more charity I give. The closer I get to God, the less I ask for repayment for what I give you. Y'all ever notice something about Bishop? When y'all borrow money from Bishop, he don't run you down for it.
Amen.
Huh? Because it's charity. And if it took that for you not to ask me for some more, thank you. Hello? I don't run you down. It's charity. If I can't afford not to give it back, if I cannot afford not to get it back, you'll be a fool to give it. But there's nothing I won't give because I know I have access to the one that has everything. So when you know the love of God, you walk in charity, you walk in charity, you walk in charity, you walk in charity. But there can be no charity without faith and hope.
Come on
now. And the faith is not. And I always said, Lord, why you put faith before hope? I thought you had to have hope in order to get faith. But I have faith and I hope for you. I have faith in God. And I hope for you, and the two coming together, take me to a place of charity. I always wondered, well, you gotta have hope before you can have faith, because you gotta hope, and then when God feels the hope, now the next time it comes around, I have faith. But God said, I know what I was doing. I went to the first honor me, and then honor them in the hope. Hope for them, and hope that they can match your hope. If they match your hope, then that one day. I like this. Hope and hope equals faith.
All right.
So God said, give them hope. You can't give a person faith again because you can't complete them. Read that again, Pastor.
From the King James Version. Charity suffereth long.
Charity. Y'all don't mean to get to that next word. That's what's wrong. Charity says it's going to cost me something that I don't have to cost myself. I got to pay for something that don't look like I'm getting my money's worth. It means I got to pay for something that might not, that don't look like I'm getting my money's worth. Charity says when I give, now, whether you give it back or not, I have decreased, and if I decrease in a place when I'm in need, and that's where God wants us to decrease, in a place where we have need, because he wants it to be a sacrifice. He wants us to decrease in a place we have need, because he wants it to be a sacrifice. So now I am no longer a sheep because I chose to sacrifice. I chose to decrease when there was a need, saying I am no longer a sheep. I am a lamb. And God said, before the sheep get fed, I'm going to feed the lambs. He told Peter, he said, Peter, do you love me? He said, yes, Lord, I love you. He said, feed my lambs. Most people will never hear that part because they don't never hear them. They never see themselves as lambs. If you had asked me, if you had to walk on the street and say, when Peter said, what did God tell Peter to feed? What the world gonna say? Sheep. Because they see themselves as what? Sheep. But you will say, he first said, feed my lambs, because you know you are a living sacrifice if you are a child of God. And then he said, Peter, do you love me a second time? And then he told Peter, Peter, feed my sheep. No, he didn't. He said, take care of my sheep. And the third time he said, feed my sheep. But I said all that to say this. I am incomplete. And the reason I'm incomplete because I won't let God do what he want to do with me. They go let Peter again. Peter, why every time we reference Jesus and Peter just did something wrong. But yet God made him the chief apostle. Y'all notice that? Every time you look at Peter, he told Peter, he said, Peter, who they say I am? Peter came out, boy. Peter came out with one boy. Peter said, you are the Son of God. And then God told him, Jesus told him, flesh and blood didn't give you that. And in the same chapter, Peter came, God told Peter what had happened. And Peter come back and said, well, I ain't gonna let that happen to you, blah, 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 blah. And Jesus said, Satan, get behind me. But notice what Peter did when Jesus told him, and this is the message we miss. In the message of washing the feet, Pastor. Charity. Sacrifice. In washing the feet, Jesus looked like he didn't have to look. He bowed down to those that he was greater than, but he made himself less than, and he wasn't washing feet, he was washing fishermen's feet. I'm not a stink fisherman's feet either. Can you imagine a fisherman's feet? They said, what is the stinkiest feet you can wash? I'll say a fisherman's feet. Unless you smell Maurice Fiesta basketball game. But anyway, here he is. But this, all that washing the feet, we missed it. Here go Peter again. You will never wash my feet. But what did Jesus tell him? Except I wash your feet, you can never belong to me. This is where we miss it in life. Except you let me do what I want to do with you.
All right.
Except you let me do what I want to do with you. I never saw that until this morning when I was meditating. How many times have I preached on washing the feet? And he said, except I wash your feet. You can never belong to me. Except you let me do what I want to do with you, you can never belong to me. Except you let God do what he want to do with you. Except you let God do what he want to do with you. You can't belong to him. And if I don't let God do what he want to do with me, I'll always be incomplete. Because I'll be a person without a purpose, not living a purpose. Oh, Jesus.
All right, purpose.
I'll be a person, I'll be a person with a purpose. Living a life as if I'm a person without a purpose is what I mean to say. I'll be a person with a purpose, living a life without a purpose if I don't let God do what he want to do with me. He said, you can never belong to me, and if you can't don't belong to me, how can you keep telling the world that you, oh yeah, you can say that. You can say you know of me. I'm a man, a woman, of God, I'm a man of God, I'm a woman of God, but I don't belong to God unless I'm a man or woman sent by God. Because if I'm sent by God, I don't just know of him, I know him.
Okay.
In order for me to tell her to go somewhere, she got to know me, and I got to know her, and I got to send her, but if I just know of her, I she could talk to me all day, because I don't know her voice, I don't know she's talking to me, because I have not taking time out to study the Bible, and then I have not taken time out to study the behavior which says God is in the midst of Jesus. So you'll never get to the Father except you learn his voice through the Bible, and you learn the his behavior through the way Jesus walked in the midst of him.
Yes.
You'll never. And as long as I don't know God, I'm incomplete. I need you to pass. Keep reading that for me.
Charity suffering long and is kind.
Suffering while serving. That's all he just said. Kind while suffering. You make me suffer, I'm kind to you. I'm serving God. Say it again, Pastor.
Charity suffering long and is kind.
Suffering long. She put me through it. And the problem is, we go to the one that's putting us through it and to the one that created the one that's putting us through it. Yeah. That's why I can't deal with the one that's put me through it.
That's right.
can't change my wife. My wife can't change me. Women, y'all man come in here and did something you don't want him to do. You're there fussing and fussing and fussing. All you're doing is making him do it again.
Well,
she fussed with, and y'all just give us admonition. Well, she fussed when I'm there, she fussed when I ain't there, so hell, she gonna fuss anyway.
Yep.
Y'all hear what I'm saying? But I tell you something, whip him! Y'all, I'm actually, that's right, whip him! Go to his daddy. Tell his daddy what his son is doing. And this is why you know you're going to get served back, because you tell your daddy what the son is doing to the daughter. You're going to hear the word of God. You hear what I'm telling you?
Yeah, come on.
You go to the daddy.
Yeah.
Whoop him.
You're right on that.
And you tell the daddy what the son is doing to the daughter, and vice versa. You tell the daddy what the daughter is doing to the son, but you waste of going to each other. You waste of going to each other.
Come on now.
Right now.
All you're going to do is get amity. All you're going to do is glorify Satan even more. You're going to throw around your ungodly vocabulary.
Yeah.
You MF. You donkey. I mean, when you throw around your ungodly vocabulary, you're saying your teacher is not the godly one, but then. Ungodly. Y'all want to hear me this day. That's all right. This is me, all right. All right. Keep reading for me, Pastor. They'd rather hear you read than me preach. Keep reading.
Charity envieth not.
Huh?
Yeah.
Charity ain't jealous?
Yeah.
And y'all, I've been trying to, God, I'm trying to, you and y'all make me jealous of my daughter. Yeah. Oh, my pastor. Oh, she is a great teacher. Do you know how many times the devil I'm trying to use y'all to make me jealous of my own daughter?
Amen.
And I said, how can you make me jealous when God allowed me to raise and grow into something like that?
Hallelujah.
Huh?
Hallelujah.
You got to, who eyes am I seeing this thing
through?
If I'm seeing it through the eyes of Satan, I'm saying, yes, they love her more than they love you. They ain't never talk about you like that when you was the bishop and you were the only pastor. Yeah, look at all you do. She ain't doing half of what you do. But look how they praising her. But you gotta understand something. What father, especially in my case, even if she was not my paternal daughter, say you were the pastor and you came out of the ministry of the Spirit of Jesus, what father wouldn't want to see his daughter blossom? They tell me if I don't want to see you blossom, I'm jealous of you. I'm still in daddy stage, not father stage. Come on, somebody.
All right.
Read to me, Pastor.
Charity vaunteth not itself.
Huh? I had no problem when God said, I'm going to make you sick so you can see what she can do.
Come on.
See, I thought I got sick because I needed a rest, but I got sick one man down, next man up. Be it a man or a woman, one man down, next man up. And if the man up can hold a position to carry the title, God said, I put them there and I want you to see that they're capable of doing what they're doing. So you got a husband. Even if he's not doing what he's supposed to be doing, you got a wife. Even if she's not doing what she's supposed to be doing, you got a church member, even if they're not doing what they're supposed to be doing, God allowed them not to do it. But that's a deacon. God gave him the title. That's a wife. God gave her the title. I'm a husband. God gave me the title. To see if you will activate the doing of the title.
Amen.
I like that. I like that.
I activate the doing of him being a deacon by going to God and not to him. I activate the doing of her being a pastor by going to God on her behalf and not to her. She activate me being a husband by going to God and not to me. I cannot activate myself.
Yes, yes.
In other words, hello somebody.
Come
hope this works. In other words, here we go. Y'all looking? Hello. No activation. It takes something outside of itself to activate it. You're trying to activate humanality. You're trying to activate humanality. Human trying to activate human. Cannot do it.
Uh-huh.
Human. Talk all day. Human. Human going to God to get a battery to activate. Going to God to get a spirit of a husband.
Yeah, come on now.
Now it talks like a husband.
Uh-huh.
Human going to God to get the spirit of a wife. I go to God for my wife. Now
she talks like a wife.
Human going to God to get the spirit of a missionary. Now she
talks like a missionary.
You can't activate yourself.
Come on now.
Human can't activate human.
My God.
You ain't complete without God. And I cannot complete myself with God.
I gotta
make people love me to the fact that they don't want nothing to happen to me and they'll go to God on my behalf.
Yeah.
I need some activation up in here. I need some activation up in here. Does anybody love me? Take it off. Does anybody love me to go to God on my behalf enough in spite of where I am?
Hey, let that red jacket talk today. Come on now.
Come on, Holy Spirit.
Jesus, Lord, have mercy and good.
I need some activation.
Amen. Woo! Jesus is good.
I got the knowledge that I need some activation.
Yeah.
In the area of addiction in my life, I need somebody to activate me. Would you go to God on my behalf and activate me?
Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah.
I can't do it for myself. I can talk to this mic all day long, but until somebody go to God and say, he or she needs some activation. He or she needs a battery. A battery, not that will run out, but we need one of them jackrabbit batteries, one of them everlasting energizers. I'm upset with my wife. She don't need to give me back me. My wife, I'm upset with my wife. She don't, the worst thing she can do is give me back me.
Yeah.
How's she gonna give you back me? Human for human.
Now you will.
Human for human. I don't need right now. Humanity already got me mad. Now you gonna give me some more humanity. You gonna throw gasoline on top of kerosene, and now I'm already burning. Somebody to say, you know what? Yeah, I'm sure gonna do it. Mr. Mallon, you need prayer, baby.
Instead of
telling the man that he's out of his mind, you need to show him some activation by loving him. But you could stay over there because you're not an activator of the Spirit of Jesus.
All right now.
Now respond to that when you're blocked.
Come on, Bishop.
Oh, Jesus.
Thank you, dog. Appreciate it. Oh, yeah, we're on another page with it. But I just said, I like to say this, lady. Mm. Just love them.
Come on now.
Be charitable.
Charity.
Charity says, I'm giving away what I ain't got enough to give it away, but that little that I do have, here it is.
Charity, come on now.
Yeah, read, Pastor.
Rejoiceth not in iniquity, but rejoiceth in the truth.
Amen. What? What?
Amen.
Bishop, why are you so blessed? Because I don't lie about my mess. You walk around and you're negative because you're ashamed of your mess.
Amen.
And God's saying, I would look crazy. I would look crazy, Pastor. I would look crazy, Pastor, blessing you when you ain't even confessed your mess to yourself. So I know if you ain't confessing to yourself, you're still trying to think you're hiding from me, meaning God. When you ain't confess your message to yourself, you know what you really think? God don't see it.
That's right.
How foolish you are. But when you confess, you leave common sense, you get some spiritual sense that God knows all things. God sees all things. And God knows all things. And he takes care of everything that he knows. I know I made you a mess, Missionary Irma. Now tell me what I already know and let me get to work on those who think I'm mad at you. Oh, Jesus. Y'all, I'm going to start selling this. I ain't doing no more Facebook. I'm gonna start bothering this and taping it up and selling it. This is just too good.
Come on now. Come on.
My God. God said, I know you're a mess. Now, let's touch and agree in your mess. That is one thing to touch and agree with your brothers and sisters, but when I confess my mess, I touch and agree with God, and he said, now others will learn from your mess as they see me bless you while you messing.
There they go,
Pastor. This sure smell bad. But God got him riding in the Mercedes. This is so smell bad, but look at his house.
My God.
God knows what matters to people. Eventually, they'll overlook the smell and start trying to get from you what God gave you.
Amen.
And you want them to get that way. Let them know that, you know what, even though I smell bad as you, God, I'm telling you, God is still with me. He's allowed me to smell like this to see if you're with me because of the smell of what he gave me.
Come on.
Anybody will go to somebody who got and ain't smelling.
Yeah.
But when you overlook the smell, watch this now. When you overlook the smell because of the blessing that God has given them, I ain't never did my happiness once. Well, so that one woman say, I ain't never did that. Please, just help me out. Even though you done did it, that look like she's a, well, who is that? Okay. Oh, yeah. She looking good, though. She might have sharp. I ain't know. She don't know when to come. She go to other churches sharp like that. She don't never come home sharp like that. But you sharp today. You had the spirit of teeth. You ain't at one of them other churches. Last time I saw you that job, you was in Miami at another church. But you look good, girl. Listen to what I'm saying, y'all. I want one woman to say, I ain't never been like that. Okay. I'm going to show you something. I'm going to show you something. You overlook the smell to get with somebody who wants. You changed your baby diaper, didn't you?
Ooh.
You changed that baby diaper. Because you loved it and you didn't care about them.
Yeah.
That's the way God wants you to love your brothers and sisters of his. He wants you to overlook the smell and change their diaper by what? Giving them charity.
All right.
So don't tell me you can't do it. And even if you don't find too many fathers. Now you want to find a father? I wasn't too good a father. Because I wasn't with you. But when I kept them by myself, I had no choice but to show the love of changing it.
Amen.
Hello?
Amen.
I know some dads will wait till the mama come home.
Right on.
I ain't say some fathers. I know some dads.
They will.
And you better hurt me. This boy soiled his pants. I'm trying to say is, when you love, you don't pay up no attention to the smell.
Yeah.
My wife can stay with me because she don't pay no attention to my smell. And most times our smell is our bondage.
Amen.
Hello?
Yeah.
Do y'all hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So if I can't tolerate somebody's smell, that means I'm incomplete. Because the truth be told, I also go to the bathroom.
Hello.
Oh, Jesus.
Hello.
Stop, Bishop. Stop. Stop. I tolerate mine. Stop, Bishop. You're getting a little bit too raw today. Rawness is the truth.
That's right.
Let's speak it. I hear somebody talking about, well, y'all don't need no Febreze when I get through. You're right. You're right, you need Glade, Febreze, and all of it at the same time. Do y'all understand what's going on here? I'm incomplete if I can only tolerate the fragrance, the good fragrance. I'm incomplete. God said anybody will work when the fragrance is, the aroma is pleasing. He said, but those who work for me, such as mothers and fathers, they work even when the aroma, they work even harder when the aroma, watch this, is not pleasant. Why? Because they don't want nothing of theirs being talked about that I allowed it to smell. Mm. So how can you say you're a child of God and will allow your brother and sister going through what he or she is going through and you will allow them to smell and you know God is all y'all fathers?
Right.
You incomplete, baby.
There
is nothing that is supposed to smell if I know that they are my spiritual, that's my wife, but yet my spiritual sister. I am not going to let her smell. I learned how not to let you smell by the way I treat her, especially when she makes me what? Angry. That's where I learned. In her place of, I ain't going to do it, angritizing me. In her place of angritizing me, I've learned how to treat you through treating her. She's learned how to treat y'all through the way she treats me when she's upset. If you can't love what you're supposed to love, forget about, you ain't never faking what you ain't supposed to love. Oh my God, incomplete. I need God to complete me. We all right? Pastor, read it over for me.
When I was a child.
Wait a minute. When I was a child, I threw temper tantrums. I had a covering. I had somebody to whoop my behind to unchild me when I acted like a child.
Come on now.
My mindset was, I'm allowed to throw temper tantrums if I got enough behind to better whoop it. You act up right here, I'm gonna whoop your behind right here. That's what my mama told me. Yeah. See, y'all had good moms waiting you get home. Oh, I didn't have one of them right there. She pulled it out right there. Bam, 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 bam. You act up right here, you get whooped right here. See, because you gotta understand, when you wanna train a dog not to poop, you put his nose in the poop right where it is. You don't take the poop poop outside and then say, hey, smell it. No, you poop right here, bam, bam, get that newspaper. Pop him in that poop with his nose to it. You act up right here. So when I was a child, I had somebody covering me in my temper tantrums.
Mm-hmm.
Bringing me up in the way that I should go.
Amen.
Huh? You can't, you better, if you coming all that way, y'all better get that paper. Y'all gonna keep him. You're stuck with him, you're breaking. That's your job. You better take him to the meeting or something.
Oh my God.
Do y'all understand what's going on here?
Amen.
When I was a child, I was allowed to throw temper tantrums. When I get mad, what am I doing? Throwing a temper tantrum. That's all. Half a man, boy. Half a woman, girl.
Uh-huh.
You supposed to be helping the children with their temper tantrum. You too busy having one of your own.
Hello.
She said, I'm busy. She said, I'm going to see it because I know I'm on that street right there. You all on my street, Bishop. I ain't call your name, so they don't know what I'm talking to. So don't say that. Don't say leave. No. Most of the time when I talk about people, they say, oh, God. Then you tell them who you're talking about. But you cannot teach a child not to have. All children do is imitate their parents.
That's right.
They see you go off on a teacher that says, you know what, my mama ain't going to let this teacher go off on me, so now I can go off on a teacher because my mama done got to stay one time. So what you got to say, teacher? My mama coming back. No, you still going out. Whether the teacher was right or wrong, you know how you make her obey, him or her obey the teacher? Whether the teacher was right or wrong, you whoop him or her behind right there in front of the teacher. And from that day forward, they'll listen to the teacher because they don't want you on their behind.
Come on.
Y'all with me here?
Amen.
Are y'all listening to this?
Amen.
In other words, right now I'm trying to teach grown people how not to throw temper tantrums so they can teach children how to behave.
Amen.
We ain't supposed to be teaching them. And we teach them not by what we tell them to do, but what they see us do.
Amen. Come on.
Hello?
Right.
I want you to see your bishop go through trouble, but never get angry or stop loving anybody.
Uh-huh.
I want you to see your bishop, no matter what the world throws his way, he never takes it out on you.
Amen.
I want you to understand that when he said, except I wash your feet, Peter, except I wash your feet, Peter, you can't belong to me. Except you let me do what I want to do with you. God said, except you let me do with that life that I gave you, what I want with it, you can't belong to me. You can't preach for me. You can't get to the wisdom that belongs to me. Except you let me do what I want to do with your life.
Amen.
Except God build a house. You labor in vain.
Uh-huh.
So what most of us are doing, we're trying to complete ourselves. I remember when I was incomplete, Pastor, and I said, if I just had one more car, if I had a bigger house, I gotta work harder so I can get the other car. I gotta work harder so I can get the bigger house. And when I got the bigger house, instead of being unmiserable, I became Tanisha more miserable. I'm not going to do that to her because I know he wasn't. But she said,
Tanisha Thompson.
There's a Tanisha Moore misery and a Tanisha Thompson misery. She said, you go trying to complete yourself, you're going to end up with that Tanisha Thompson misery. Do y'all hear what I'm saying here?
Amen.
All you do is bring yourself more misery. Well, you don't, y'all might as well get comfortable because I'm just getting started. When you don't let God do what he want to do with your life, God said, the more you, the less him, and you ain't got no, you got driver's license, but you ain't got no godly driver's license yet.
Mm-hmm.
You can't get driver's license until the state authorize you to drive.
Mm-hmm.
You can't get spiritual driver's license until God authorize you to drive spiritually.
Amen.
And I don't know about y'all, I don't know how they do it today, but I remember when I wanted my license, we used to have to get these little driver's license books. Y'all remember them?
Yeah.
They were hard to get to.
Yeah.
I mean, we get them, and then the bad thing about it was, once one person got them, you passed around to all your friends. By the time you got them, you flunked the test, and they done ripped out half the papers to take them to the test to cheat off them.
So true.
So what I'm trying to say to you is, you got to, we had to have a source. We had to go to a place to study. And what I'm trying to say is the church is the place to study. Then you will never get your spiritual driver's license unless you keep going to the place to study. But one thing about God, when you study from the Bible, they might rip the pages out. But when you study from his spirit, there's no pages to rip.
All right.
When you study from his spirit, there are no pages to rip. I just can't get off you today, LaToya, because the thing about it is I just can't get over the fact 3 months ago you just called the lady and said, I want to come to church. She didn't want nothing but peace. She didn't want nothing. And she didn't even know that. At least when I'm in that church, I feel closer to my grandma. You didn't think I knew that, but anyway. But whatever, she didn't want nothing, no house, no car, no money. She just wanted to come to church to be closer to God, and to be closer to what brought her to God, and Sister Leola, but she just wanted to come to church for that reason, and God said, because you didn't ask me for nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Solomon, what do you want? Solomon said, Lord, I want wisdom and knowledge. God said, because you didn't ask for riches, I'm going to make you wealthy. Uh-huh. Most people come to church talking about, I'm going to be prosperous. Prosperity is what I'm going to get. I'm going to serve the Lord, and I'm going to serve until he make me a millionaire. Whatever the devil know you're chasing, that's what the Lord's going to give him room to touch. Whatever your heart is chasing, you're chasing money, God said, devil, just have your way with them, their finances. If you're coming to church for a husband, God said, just have your way with their date life. You're coming to church for anything other than God, whatever you're coming for other than God, God said, devil, have your way in that area of their
life.
Have that way. Have your way. Until they come for me, they'll always be incomplete. I'm coming for one reason. I want God to make me who I'm supposed to be.
Amen.
But most of us can't get there because we have already painted a picture of who we want to be.
All right now.
And when I paint a picture of who I want to be, now I go into battle with God when he don't make me who I'm supposed to be. When he don't make me who I want to be, but make me who I'm supposed to be. I go into battle with God. I went into battle with God when I became a pastor. I mean, but God would not let me go to the church that day because he knew I had a zeal for preaching. Now, if I didn't have a zeal for preaching the day that I was supposed to go back and preach to the church, I wouldn't be a pastor today. So God would put something in your life to draw you to him, but you would not want the purpose that in which he is drawing you. So I did not want to be a pastor. So he had me preaching at Christ Compassionate Deliverance Center for 3 years. And then one day he calls and said, tell your husband I want him to pastor the church. God. And I told her, tell him he must be a lost his mind. I didn't answer the man for 2 weeks. I go, man, but it was my time to preach. See, I like preaching. So God knew if I was just going to church every third Sunday just to go, that Sunday I wouldn't have went. But he had a target for me. He said, you got to go preach. And when I went to preach, the bishop pulled me aside. He said, son, I said, well, Rev, him. I said, Rev, let me tell you something, bishop. And this is no lie. Look down there like this. I said, before you say anything, here's a list. There were 10 things on that paper of why I can't preach. Pastor this church. I didn't want to be a pastor. I didn't beg to be a pastor. But look what I would have missed if I had not accepted what God said I was supposed to be. So I gave the paper. He got the paper. He balled it up. He said, I know about all your issues. I give you none. He said, I know about all your issues. He said, but God told me to make you the pastor of this church. He didn't say anything. Well, your wife likes coming to this church. You know, your daughter a member of this church. You know, your grandkids go to this church. He didn't say any junk like that. I wouldn't be standing here today. There was only one thing. You know when you're watching the Family View and there's four answers on the board and they done got the first three. Now you got to say the exact thing to get the final one to win the game. He didn't say anything but answer number four. He said, God told me. And this is where I want to wrap this sermon up. You got to let God talk to you, and whatever he says, you do it, whether you understand it as good, bad, right, wrong, you know the voice of God. Amen. It's him.
That's right. That's right.
It was not right for me to become a pastor with a drug addiction. Not right. Not right. Do y'all hear what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Nothing in my heart said this was right. But look at the righteousness that come out of this old wicked, wretched place.
My God.
It's not right. Most of us say, that's just wrong. But look what God can do out of something that looks wrong to you.
Yes.
He said, God knows what he's doing when he said, God told me to make you. He said, God knows what he's doing. When he said, God told me to make you, and I come to tell you today, I love you exactly where you are. I love you exactly for who you, who God has made you.
Come on now.
I mean, I married a lady. I married a lady that had three of my children from other men.
Amen.
Another man. Do you hear what I'm telling you?
Amen.
A woman had my children from another man. Three! But Niecy, Junior, Sean, what they go through.
Amen.
Huh? If I ain't got it, especially them girls, I find it for them. Pastor.
Amen.
Because they mine. I don't disrespect their natural fathers at all. I'm sorry. Excuse me. As this one said one day, you my daddy, but Maurice is my
father.
I come to tell you today, God is your father. She's all that she can be today because she knows I have faith in her. And I'm gonna tell y'all what God told me, and I'm gonna tell y'all what I tell all my kids all the time, and my wife. You can't do no wrong in my eyes. Spirit of Jesus members, you can't mess up bad enough that you know why you stopped coming last time? Because you done messed up again. No, that's a blessing, baby. And God's going to send a father one day. You hear what I'm telling you? And he's going to embrace them. Will he embrace them, Pastor?
Yes, he will. Yeah. Yes, he will.
In a father's eyes, their child can't do no wrong.
Yeah.
And we learned that from the father.
Amen.
In a mother's eyes, their child can do no wrong. And they learned that from the love of God, because there's no love like a mother's love. Hello, somebody.
Amen.
And the only way that we're going to be complete is we take time out, we study the Bible, we study Jesus, until one day Jesus said, guess what, I got something for you. I'm going to take you to my father's house and drop you off, because no longer do I have to talk to him for you. And whatever he says, you accept it. That's righteousness, not right or wrong. Do y'all hear what I'm saying today?
Yeah.
He said, confess your sins unto yourself. Then I know you have to stop trying to hide from him, not them.
All right now.
Because what you're trying to hide from these Negroes, they already got something about anyway. And they ain't got no heaven or hell to put you in. Hello, somebody.
Amen.
So everybody know what you could you think you have. Ain't that something? God knows. They know. But you just walk around like don't nobody know. Why do you think when you go to church? I mean, I used to go to church and I've been did something wrong the night before. I mean, looking around the church like, God, it looks like everybody looking at me. Anybody been there besides me?
My God.
Am I the only one been there? And I started doing so much, I just said, I ain't going to let no people look at me like that.
Amen.
Huh? But them people ain't got no heaven or hell to put you in.
That's right.
They can't complete you.
That's right.
The one that created you is your completer.
Right.
Your husband ain't your completer. Your spouse ain't your completer. God is your completer. I need you right now today. Read, watch this. I'm ready to leave y'all. KK in my spirit right now.
I understood as a child.
I understood as a child.
I thought as a child.
I thought as a child.
But when I became a man.
When I became whole, when I stopped throwing temper tantrums. Hello, women. Hello, I'm sorry. Hello, girls. Hello, boys. When you stop getting mad and acting out, you now are no longer thinking like a child. Why you smile? You working on that? God gonna work on it for you, because confess, that's where I'm at, okay? I didn't say, Lord, don't say it right now, but when you get home, say, Lord, I need help. What bitch you talk about today? I'm gonna say it. I don't know about y'all, I'm gonna say it. Because as close as I am, I'm not there. I'm gonna take you somewhere. Read, Pastor.
I put away childish things.
I stopped doing the most childish thing I can do is a good man. That's the most childish thing I can do. Not what I say. But leaving God. Confess that thing to God. Read, Pastor.
For now we see through a glass.
Now we see through a glass. I like this part. Read.
Darkly, but then face to face.
Y'all ever see there's a scripture that says I look in the mirror, as soon as I leave the mirror, I forget what I look like? Huh? You look in the mirror, and when you look in the mirror, you see the creation of God. But as soon as you leave the mirror, you forget it because you start acting like anything but a creation of God. When I look in the mirror, I see a creation of God. But when I leave the mirror, I forget what I look like because I stop acting like that creation. Read, Pastor. Do y'all understand what I'm saying? I hope somebody need a pedicure when I get through today. Anybody need a pedicure? Need to hurt your feet today? Am I stepping on some toes? Am I stepping on some toes? And they say amen.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah, that's why I come. I come to step on your toes. Because King Sing needs some pedicure money. Read, Pastor.
Now I know in part. But then shall I know even as also I am known.
Now, I know completely because I understand the only way that I'm completed by God, I always keep my peace. I never let anybody interrupt my peace because if they interrupt my peace, that still tells me I don't believe God is real. But there is peace, there is God. When God is there, he will work your circumstances out sooner than later. Read.
And now abideth faith.
Now abideth faith.
Hope.
Wait. Read the whole thing.
And now abideth faith, hope, charity, these three, but the greatest of these is charity.
Okay. Now when I hear that right now, now abideth faith, hope, and charity. And of these three, the greatest of these is charity. Which is the greatest? Out of that sentence, which is the most powerful word? Huh? 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 Say it again, Pastor. Huh? Now that is in me is faith, hope, and charity put there by God, which completes me. That's a trick question when you hear that statement in that context. I can know about charity. I can know about faith. I can know about hope. But if it ain't in me, I'm not complete. Now abideth in me. Now, it didn't say living, it said abideth. That's eternal. Ain't never supposed to go nowhere. Ain't never supposed to give away my peace. Ain't never supposed to be in an unpeaceful state. Ain't never supposed to throw a temper tantrum. Because I cannot throw God away when I know that he's abiding in me. I'm opening the door and saying, get your dairy out of here, God, because right now I need them to see who I am. Now abideth in me. Did you get that? And if you heard this sermon today via Facebook, via social media, or live, or either rebroadcast, you need to go ask God to make sure you know what is abiding in you and to let you confess what you need to confess so it can be released forevermore. Everybody needs to be on their knees when they leave here today. And when we pray today, you can stand or you can get on your knees right now. As I'm going to. Because I might not make it to my house. I might not make it to my the kneel down on the side of my bed. I might not make it to my living room. I want that abundance of faith, hope, and charity. And I don't ever want to throw it away again. For nobody. Amen. Or nothing. Because when I got faith, hope, and charity, I got faith in God to give hope to you to say that I will charitize you to the point that you have that same faith.
My Lord, God bless, yes.
Complete. When he abides in you, you are complete. As I pray, you can stand or kneel, whichever is comfortable for you. Father, we come in the name of Jesus. We pray not right now for each and every one that is in this sanctuary. I thank you right now, Lord, for showing me the deficits and not the places where people glorify me. I need my deficits, Lord, because in my deficits is where I need to confess so I can see you work. I pray right now that each and every one in this sanctuary and each and every one on the social media broadcast have recognized their deficits, and they're willing to confess their deficits so they can receive the abundance of your God. We thank you right now, Lord, for letting us know that you're abiding in us. And what says that your abundance is real is that even in the season of corona, we yet have peace. That there's no sickness that God can't heal. We thank you right now in the name of Jesus, Lord. For those who are not coming to church because they fear something more than they fear you. We pray for them right now, Lord. We're not mad at them. We're standing in their stead, Lord. We're walking in the completeness of interference, through running interference so the devil can't have his way with him or her. We're giving charity right now. We're not doing this for them to come to church. We're doing this because this is our deed for the need. Bless those, Lord, whose hearts are waning right now, and I feel them getting faint. I feel them think that you're not moving fast enough, but they don't understand. The longer they wait on you, it's because you're taking time to prepare a greater blessing. Take your time with my blessing, Lord. Take your time with the blessing of the Spirit of Jesus. Take your time, Lord, with what I want out of my life. Take your time with taking it out, Lord, because I know when it comes out, the longer you take, the greater I'm going to be blessed for not complaining while you took your time. We thank you right now, Lord. We pray for all mothers right now, Lord, that have lost control of their children. Let them stop arguing at the children and fussing at the children and go to the child's creator, which is you. And now, Lord, when they come to you knowing that you can do all things but fail, Lord, you'll give them back to them. You'll bring them back with a mind that says, I don't know why, Mama, but I'm sorry. And I won't do it no more. Mama, I don't know. But as long as you're trying to fix what you did not create, you're going to create more animosity. I thank you for teaching us, Lord. I thank you for making us whole, Lord, and know that we are without because we don't go to the one who gave us everything and has the avail to give us everything. We got life. God said, if I gave you life, why won't I give you everything that makes the life peaceful and joyful and one with me? But you think you are the one to complete your life. You think you are the one to complete yourself. You think you are the one to complete your children. You think you're the pastor to complete the members. You think you're the bishop to complete the members. You think you're the one to complete your spouse. How wrong we are. My spouse is incomplete because I won't go to God and let God make me the activating battery to take them to where they can't take themselves. We keep talking and talking through a microphone without a battery to activate it. And we don't want to be the battery because we worry about how much time it's going to take us, how long we're going to wear our knees out. Me and my, I ain't got no more knees because of you. Some people have told me that. But I thank God, if I ain't got no more knees because of you, that means we have to wait a little bit longer for the great blessing that God is preparing for you. I've already got mine because I haven't understood that God is building this house. And I'm now, I want you to get out of the way so he can complete you and build yours. We thank you now, Lord, as we pray. And as we pray, we will not stop trusting you in all things. Because, Lord, you're almighty. Because you're mighty for all. Yeah. We thank you in Jesus' name. Jesus. For all things this day and forevermore. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.